In this video, I want to show you how to install the base layer of any torch down roofing system. It's going to be either glass base or Polyglass Elastobase. Let's get into it. All right, so the purpose of the base layer of any torch down system is really for fireproofing. Torch down systems are not fire rated as far as like the cap sheet or the mid plies. So the base layer is what gives us our fireproofing. In California and most cities, we need class A fire rating. And in order to achieve that, what we need to do is install two layers of glass base. Glass base is a fiberglass mat pretty much that has granules on both sides. If you're using glass base as your base layer, you have to install two layers. In this demo, we're going to be installing Polyglass's base sheet. The reason we like it is thicker than glass base. The backside kind of looks the same as glass. However, the front side has a smooth surface that actually has a bitumen surface on it, so it does a great job bonding to the second and third layers of the roof. And on top of that, you just need to install one layer. But essentially, both of these, whether you install glass base, two layers, or one layer of this, you're still gonna be getting your Class A fire rating. Let's get into it. All right, the first thing you wanna do is lay out your rolls. We've laid out our first roll here. You can see it's just loose laid on top of the plywood. Now you wanna go in the same direction that your regular torch down or your top rolls are gonna be going. So in this case, we're draining to this point right here. And you know, in our mark, we've got a scupper here. So we're gonna be installing our top rolls this way. So we've got our base sheet laid already. Now we're ready to start nailing. You can see here there are these marks marked at 12 inches from the edge. And along these marks, we're gonna be nailing every 18 inches on center. What we are using is ring shank metal cap nails. So what these do is, first of all, we need to have metal, so when we're torching our top layer, the metal does not melt, and the ring shank helps it grab onto the plywood. So anytime we're coming on overlaps here, we want to lap one layer over the next, a minimum of 4 inches. And Polyglass has this marked out so that makes our job super easy. We just follow that 4 all the way across, lay it down. Now on this lap here, where we have two layers going over each other, we're gonna be putting nails in every 9 inches on center. Instead of the field where we're doing around 18, around the edges, we want to do closer together. You can see here along this edge where we have this overlap, we've installed nails every 9 inches on center. There's two reasons for that. The first one is we want to make sure we have a smooth transition when we have this double layer here. Second and most important is we want to make sure that this is nice and tight so that when we're torching the next layer on top of it, we don't have any flames going in underneath that. Because again, remember, this base layer is super important for fireproofing purposes. So we want to make sure that all these edges are tight so that when we're torching, we don't risk getting down to the wood layer. All right, so in this mock roof, we have a parapet wall build out on this side. You can see here that we already have our can strip installed. This can strip is pretty much just allowing us to break this corner and have a more rounded, smoother transition. When installing your base layer on your roof, you want to make sure that you come up and past the can strip at least an inch or two. You don't have to go all the way up the parapet wall, as that makes it a lot harder. The way we like to do it and the way manufacturer recommends is to come up this parapet wall, pass the can strip, cut it, terminate your rolls there, then come in with a new piece depending on the height of your parapet wall, and install this base layer. And when you install the base layer on your parapet wall, you want to make sure you come past that count strip, so this corner you have a double layer. Now that we've finished installing the base, I want to show you a few details. You can see, first off, this edge right here is not nailed down, and that's done purposefully. When we install our low-rise flashing, we're going to be nailing this down, so we don't want any round cap metal nails bothering the edge right here, so that's just around the perimeter where we're going to have our low-rise flashing. You can see, like I mentioned before, we have nails every 18 inches on center in the middle, and every 9 inches on center along the seams. The nails in the center, we want to have them 12 inches from the edge, and that's going to be on both sides here, so you can see we've got two rows of nails going down. And pretty much before we start torching, we want to make sure that there's no more wood left exposed on the roof. Torching and wood don't really go hand in hand, so we want to make sure that we've fully covered our entire wood deck prior to torching. Let's continue to the next one. Guys, thanks for watching. We have a lot of other videos on this channel about torch down roofing. If we're missing anything, please comment below. We'd love to explain. Keep in mind, we are in Southern California, so we're building to our building codes and standards here in California. If there's anything that you'd like to do different, let us know below. We'd love to hear from you. Give us a like, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one.